Good morning all the students. Today I am here with the chapter Globes from the book Connect with the World, class 4th. It's a SST book and today we will discuss the uses of globes, how to see a globe and etc. So first we will do a recap of the previous taught chapter in class 3. So the earth is shaped like an orange. So this is true. The earth is also called the blue planet. Yes, this is also true. We have already discussed these things in class 3. Why it is called blue planet? Because 71% of the earth is covered with water. That is why we call it a blue planet. And it is shaped like an orange, flat on the top and flat on the bottom. So the shape of the earth is like an orange. There is no life on earth. It's false. There is life on earth. Oxygen, water, sunlight, all we are having on this earth only. The earth is the fourth planet in the solar system. So earth is the third planet in the solar system, not the fourth. It's the third. Okay, now come to the text. For a long time it was believed that the earth is flat. Ferdinand Magellan, an explorer, proved it wrong by sailing westwards and returning to the same place. So we have already discussed this thing about Ferdinand Magellan in the third class, first chapter, Earth in our solar system. So what we found there, that this traveler started sailing from westwards and again he returned to the same place. So he declared that Earth is round and it's a sphere in shape. So this would not have been possible if the earth was flat. Later many other explorers also proved that the earth is round. Today satellite pictures taken from the outer space and accounts of astronauts also prove that the earth is round in shape. So today it has been proven that earth is round in shape and flat from the top and flat on the bottom. The globe. The photograph of the earth shows that it is a huge body. We cannot see or study the entire earth at one go. Therefore, to do an in-depth study of the earth, a small model of the earth called a globe is used. So for the purpose of study, what we use? Globe. At a time we cannot have a look of the whole earth. So underline this sentence. What is globe? So the small model of the earth is called a globe. Okay, now come to page number 8. Uses of a globe. The globe is an exact replica of the earth in terms of its shape and surface. It's an exact replica. It completely looks like the earth. So it gives a fair idea of the location and shape of various landforms, continents, countries and water bodies. So this globe gives us the idea of landforms, continents, with all the places are covered with different colors. Like water is colored in the water filled places are covered colored in blue color. So all the continents and water landforms, continents, countries and water bodies are mentioned here in the globe. It's the exact replica. It completely looks like earth. So now, uses of a globe. So this is a very important paragraph. the question, we can make a question, what are the uses of a globe? So we get to learn about our earth, about the continents, about the countries, about the water bodies from globe. Okay, now important references points on a globe. So globe defines many things, many signs, many diagrams are made on this globe. So we will see the axis is an imaginary line passing through the earth's center on which the earth rotates. It's the imaginary line, not exact, but it's an imaginary line. What is axis? Axis is an imaginary line passing through. It passes from the earth center. From the earth center, it passes through on which the earth rotates. So this is called axis. It is tilted. It's little bent. Tilted means little bend. B-E-N-D. Little bend. It is tilted at an angle of 23.5 degrees. It is tilted at an, and this is a question, this is an important question, underline it. So at what degree the earth is tilted? Okay, so the rod on which a globe spins represents the earth's axis. So when you have a globe, see, this shows the axis, the rod on which globe, on which the globe spins, that is called earth's axis. This is earth's axis. This rod is called earth's axis. Okay, now come here. The northmost point of the axis is North Pole. So the northmost point. Where is the northmost point? See, this is the South Pole. This is the South Pole. This is the North Pole. The top. The top is the North Pole. This is the axis on which the rod. This is the rod on which Earth spins. And this is the North Pole. This is the South Pole. Okay, South Pole and North Pole, fine. So North Pole and the South, southernmost point is the South Pole, northernmost point is the North Pole, and southernmost point is the South Pole. Halfway between the North Pole and the South Pole lies an imaginary line called the equator. See, halfway, this is the equator, imaginary line. This is also imaginary line. This is the equator. This divides the earth, it's an imaginary line, into two parts. Okay, so this is also halfway between the North Pole and the South Pole lies an imaginary line called the equator. Okay, this imaginary line divides the earth into two equal halves. Each half is called hemisphere. Each half, see, all one word questions can be created from the middle of the chapter. Each one half, this is hemisphere, this is northern hemisphere, this is southern hemisphere. Clear? So, and what divides the earth into two halves? This equator. Okay, this is also an imaginary line. Axis is an imaginary line and equator is an imaginary line. Okay, fine. Now, to the north of the equator lies the northern hemisphere, and to the south lies the southern hemisphere. Fine. Now, come to the exercise, spot check. We can see the earth at one go. No. False. The earth rotates on its axis. Yes. The South Pole is the northernmost point of the Earth's axis. No, the South Pole is the southernmost point of the axis. Southernmost. The equator divides the Earth into two halves. Yes. Now, latitudes and longitudes. What are latitudes and what are longitudes? We will learn here. Latitudes, also known as parallels, are the imaginary lines running parallel to the equator. Latitudes, underline it, also known as parallels, are the imaginary lines running parallel to the equator. These lines of latitude are at an equal distance from each other. Lines of latitude are marked in degrees. The equator is marked as 0 degree. Underline it. These lines of latitude are at an equal distance from each other. Lines of latitude are marked in degrees. The equator is marked as 0 degrees. Fine. Some latitudes are the North Pole at 90 degree in the north. The Arctic Circle at 66.5 degree north. So you'll have to learn the degrees. The Tropic of Cancer, the Tropic of Capricorn at 23.5 degree south. The Antarctic Circle at 66.5 degree south. The South Pole at 90 degree south in the south. Okay. So these, N is for north, S is for south. Now come. Latitude, lines of latitude. See. Lines of latitude. This is the line. This is the equator. And this is the line. Lines of latitude go across the earth from east to west, but they measure the globe from north to south. Clear? They go from east to west. They go from east to west, but they measure the globe from north to south, starting at the equator. Longitude. Lines of longitude runs across the globe from north to south, but measure east and west, starting at the prime meridian. The grid of the lines of longitude and latitude. See, this is longitude. Latitude, this is latitude, going from east to west. East, west. And here is north, and here is south. So, see the grid. These lines are latitudes and these lines are longitudes. Clear? Longitudes are imaginary lines running through the North Pole and the South Pole. So North Pole is here, South Pole is here. So longitudes come from here to north, from north to south. Okay? Like latitudes, longitudes are also marked in degrees. The 0 degree meridian is known as prime meridian. Okay, like latitudes, longitudes are also marked in degrees. The 0 degree meridian is known as the prime meridian, which runs through Greenwich, a place near London. It divides the earth into two halves, the eastern hemisphere and the western hemisphere. There are 180 degrees of longitude east of the prime meridian and 180 degrees of longitude west of the prime meridian. In all, there are 360 degrees of longitude. The meridians to the east of Greenwich are East Meridian, and the meridians to the west of Greenwich are West Meridians. So underline this paragraph. The lines of latitude and longitude together form a crisscross pattern known as the grid on the globe. What is a grid on the globe? Like I told you, crisscross. Crisscross is latitude goes from east to west and longitude cross from north to south. So this is the imaginary line of latitude and longitude, and this is east to west latitude, north to south longitude. Clear? This is called grid. Check boxes are called grid. This helps to locate the exact position of a place on the globe. Okay, now these latitudes, longitudes, hemisphere, axis, equator, south pole, north pole, all these things, what do they help us? They help us to locate the exact position of any place, any continent, or the water bodies, landforms on the globe. They enable us to recognize the exact location on the globe. Okay, fine. Now come to the word bank. Globe, a spherical model of the earth. So you have to write HW. This is a HW. This is your HW. And this is also your HW. This is a brush up exercise of the previous class. Okay, so but you have to complete it. You have to do it in your copies, fair copies. HW, word bank. Globe, a spherical model of the earth. Axis, an imaginary line passing through the center of the earth on which the planet rotates. Hemisphere, one half of the earth. We have already told you, I have already told you, that hemisphere is the one half of the earth. Latitudes, the line running parallel to the equator. From latitudes run from east to west. East to west. The lines running parallel to the equator. Equator is where? Here. And they run parallelly, equally. From east to west. They are latitudes. Okay? Grid. A pattern of lines that forms a series of squares. As I already discussed here. Series of squares, that is grid. Okay, but this is just a rough diagram. So longitudes, the imaginary lines running through the north pole and the south pole. Longitudes, as already discussed, longitudes are imaginary line running from north to south pole. Okay. In a nutshell, a small model of the earth is called a globe. The globe gives a fair idea of the location. This is the summary of the chapter, okay? So a small model of the earth is called a globe. The globe gives a fair idea of the location and shape of the various landforms, continents, countries and water bodies, okay? An imaginary line passing through the earth's center on which the planet rotates is known as its axis. The imaginary lines running parallel to the equator are called latitudes. I hope all the things are clear over here. The imaginary lines running through the north pole and the south pole are called longitudes. That is clear? The latitudes and longitudes together form a crisscross pattern called grid on the globe. So this is clear. This is the nutshell. This is the summary. Now, exercise A. Column A, you have to match. This is match the following. You have to match column A with column B. Replica of the earth. Replica of the earth. First. Grid is imaginary lines parallel to the equator. imaginary lines from the North Pole to South Pole. Latitude, we will find out the great answer. Latitude is from east to, latitudes are from east to west, from east to west. Longitude, imaginary lines parallel to the equator. Longitudes is fourth answer is here. Okay, Tropic of Capricorn. Tropic of Capricorn, what is there? What is the degree of Tropic of Capricorn? You have to learn this. Tropic of Capricorn is 23.5 degrees south. This is the answer. Tropic of Capricorn, 5. Okay? North Pole. North Pole is imaginary lines parallel to the equator. No. Helps to find out. North Pole is 90 degree north. North Pole 90 degree north. Yes. 90 degree north. North Pole is 6th. 6th is here. Now, North Pole done. Tropic of Capricorn done. Replica of the Earth is done. Helps to find location. I think grid. Imaginary line parallel to the equator. Latitude. Yes, latitude is an imaginary line parallel to the equator, because equator runs from east to west. So this is latitude. Third. Okay. So first, now this will be the second. Grid helps to find location. So that is why I underline all the important sentences. Here we have seen grid. Grid. This helps to locate the exact position of a place on the globe. Okay. So the lines of latitude and longitude together form a crisscross pattern known as grid. What is grid? Lines of latitude and longitude together form a crisscross pattern known as the grid on the globe. This helps to locate the exact position of a place on the globe. Fine. Match the following is done. Now, circle the correct answer. A small model of the Earth is called a globe. A globe shows us the location of different continents of different countries. The northmost point on the globe is the North Pole. The imaginary lines running parallel to the equator are called latitudes. The prime meridian is a 0 degree. Prime meridian, what is the degree? Where is prime meridian? Prime meridian, where we have come across this word? Prime meridian. Prime meridian, yes, 0 degree is known as, see, the 0 degree meridian is known as the prime meridian. Okay, so prime meridian is 0 degree. Longitude, the like latitudes, latitudes and is known as prime meridian, which runs through Greenwich and divides the Earth into two parts. Place Greenwich is 0 degree prime meridian. Yes. Okay. So this is also your homework. You have to complete it in your fair copies. Okay. So Dash was an explorer who proved that the Earth is round. This you will do it on your own. Okay. C and D. Okay? C and D you will do on your own. E is I think questions, long questions. How did we get to know the actual shape of the Earth? What are the important reference points on a globe? What is the difference between latitudes and longitudes? So you will be doing this. I will send you the answer of these questions. Rest you will do this. What is the homework now? First, this is the homework. Second, spot check. This is the homework. Third, word bank. You have to complete it in your copy. Fourth, match the following. A, B, circle the correct answers. And C, fill in the blanks. C and D, you have to do it on your own. Fine? Okay, thank you. Bye-bye. Take care. Stay safe.